You're watching GTV on location.
We're at the red carpet premiere for the Outlife TV show.
We're in the building, and like I told you, we're here with Outlife. This is the cast, the crew, the people that is making this spectacular show, this TV show, what it's going to be. So I'm sitting here with the director, Miss Amber DeVos. Mm-hmm.
Tell us, what made you want to do this?
It was all Cayce Guest, the creator. He brought it to all of us, and he's the reason why we're all sitting together. It was his vision, his dream, and he approached me. We had worked together on another show together. It was a web series, and he had approached me about the idea, and I was over the top excited about participating in it. And then we met Tonina Kelly as well, who's behind me. Uh-huh. And the three of us got together, and she started writing, and we started putting just all the pieces together, and here we are.
And now here we are.
Yeah.
One of the questions I'd like to ask you is, how do you feel now that you've gone from paper to the dream, so to speak?
It's really surreal still. Tonina and I, actually, the day of the premiere, we were almost somber, if you will. We thought we were going to be really excited, but it's almost, Tonina did a great analogy. She was like, when you cook this huge meal and you work all day on
it,
and then it comes time to eat it, you're like, nah, I don't really want it anymore.
Right.
And so, I mean, we're beyond excited that it all came together, but it's also like, it's almost sad that you're at the end of it, and you know, we put all this hard work, and it's like, now we move on to the next step.
When you talk about the end of it, it's only one portion of the end, right?
It's the end of the pilot. It's the end of the pilot that all of us work together on. Now we move on to pitching and talking to networks and just working the magic as far as getting it out there for everybody to see.
So, okay, that's the next question I'll have for you.
Mm-hmm.
What is the operational gold right now to get it to that box that we are on right now?
Pitching. I mean, that's just it. We are going to be working together like crazy. We didn't lose momentum even over the weekend after the premiere.
Right.
We're packaging it together in a nice, pretty little, you know, box and sending it off to the networks and talking with lawyers and managers. And we have a lot of information and a lot of drive to get it out there. And I think we know a lot of the right people, too. So we're just ready. We're ready to get it out.
And once you put it together and you watched it, how are you going to, when you go against networks or channels that say, well, do we think that people are ready for something like this?
You know, I was talking about it earlier, and I almost think that there's going to be a bidding war over it. I really do. I don't think it's a matter of if they're ready. I think it's a matter of can they actually survive without something like this out there, because people are, they want it. They want this real life, real stories, and amazing local talent, and I honestly think that it's going to be in our court for us to decide who we want to actually have our story out there.
So let's set the scene a little bit. Mm-hmm. Let's tell people that haven't seen the trailers yet, and we'll talk about where you can see the trailers before this beautiful event is over. When you're speaking to somebody about it, when you say, have you seen that show, what is it that you'd say about the show?
Well, the tagline says it all. It's where life and hair collide.
Mm-hmm.
But it is all local Atlanta talent and very real modern issues and relationships. And there's nothing that's fake or superficial. Everything is very genuine. And it's an openly gay show, but there are heterosexuals, homosexuals, bisexuals. There's a mix of everybody and a mix of every flavor too, as far as white, black, Hispanic.
Right.
It's just a really open-minded show, and I know everybody working on it opened their hearts and minds, and I feel like I've grown just working on it, so I know people watching it will feel the same way.
Right. So okay, now let's talk about actually getting in the camera's eye and directing and doing this. How did you first come across what's going to be the first scene? How are we going to introduce everyone to the world?
That was definitely Tanina's. I mean, her writing. She put it out in a nice little package for us just to go right by the script. We just knew. We had it in our heads. Cayce and Tonina and I met so many times, and we were all on the same page, and we knew that our vision, we shared it, and there was no doubt of the direction we wanted to take it. As far as directing, this was my first time, so thank goodness I had everybody here helping me and being very forgiving when I may have slipped up or done something wrong. But I can't help say that it was just really magical how it all came together.
Okay, like I asked you when we were on the red carpet before, I'd like you to reiterate a little bit more about the question of when they say, well, a woman directing a show that's openly gay and bisexual and this and that and the other, how does that play?
You mean if they're asking me as far as if I can pull it off,
right,
kind of? Again, I think I opened my heart and my mind to the project, and hopefully other people, hopefully that shows through in the final product. I don't feel like any storyline thrown at me is right. Something I would turn my nose up to just because I may not fit the bill as right. as the stereotypical director for that job. I hope people can have an open mind when they find out that I am the director and give it a chance, because the cast pulled it off. I mean, they did it. They nailed it. And, you know, having Tonina's writing as the solid foundation of it all, I mean, it was almost handed to me in a pretty little package. Just say, here you go. I don't care, you know, what your background was. You can do it. So.
And now that we're at this stage of awareness, where would everybody go to see the pilots and the trailers and all the great back footage and things that is going to make the characters come to life until we get that premiere date, time, and hour that I know you guys will get eventually?
Absolutely. www.facebook.com/outlifeshow, www.twitter.com/outlifeshow.
What can we do as viewers, as producers, directors, to give you the support that is needed, that this won't take 2 years and a lot of hassles to get there? Because something that you said, being a director, unless you know these people, unless you've hung around in the system and know all kinds of people, that's the only way you could actually do this.
Yeah.
So in your life as a person, you know people that follow these lifestyles and traits that made it easier to bring characters in. Right?
Yeah, no, absolutely. So you're wondering how they can learn more and support
yes.
us?
Mm-hmm.
Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, share our video, the behind the scenes and the trailer, share all of those on YouTube, and just follow us as much as you can. We're not losing momentum. We're still moving forward, and we're going to continue to do appearances as much as we can to spread the word, but really showing your support would be following us on Facebook, Twitter, watch our videos on YouTube, and just share with as many people as you can.
We've got a lot more coming up. Again, my name is Danilo Ignacio, and I'm here with the cast of Outlife. We'll be back in a minute. Stay tuned. This is Gay TV.
We're with the cast and crew of the upcoming TV series, Outlife.
You're watching.
Stay tuned in for more Gay TV on location. We'll be right back.